Well, hype up the hoopla and amp up the exhilaration. American TV's Night of Nights, the Primetime Emmy Awards, they are underway as we speak at the Microsoft Theatre in Los Angeles. And for those who've lost count, look, let's be frank, it's an easy thing to do. This is the 74th Emmy Awards. So, the stars have had their stylists and their beauticians working their fingers all the way down to the bone. The glitterati have posed for photos, beamed sunny smiles for the cameras on the red carpet. Actually, as you can see there, it's a golden carpet this year, just to kind of change things up. Kenan Thompson from Saturday Night Live, he is hosting the awards. And I have an early winner to announce. This is very exciting because Australia's very own Murray Bartlett has won one of the first awards of the night. In fact, he has won Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Limited Series, and that is for The White Lotus. Here is Murray accepting his award.
My partner Matt, thank you for being my sanctuary. And finally, I just want to thank my mum all the way home in Australia for giving me the most wonderful foundation of unconditional love and inspiring me to believe that we can all do that for each other. So thank you, Mum, and thank you for this.
Oh, wow. And to think for Murray, it all began on the Flying Doctors back in the day. So, look, big congrats to Murray, and I'll be bringing you more winners later this morning as they sail through. But first, there's nothing like a look at the fashions, is there? From the sartorially splendid to those, dare I say it, fashion fiascos. You can be the judge. Let's start with Orange is the New Black and inventing Anastar Laverne Cox. Here is Laverne, sort of channeling Madonna's famous cone-shaped brassiere. Remember that particular look of Madonna's? Well, anyway, look, for those taking notes, she is wearing Jean-Paul Gaultier Couture. So there you go. Laura Linney is hoping to take home her fifth Emmy today. Now, she's nominated for Outstanding Lead Actress in a Drama, and that is for The Fabulous Ozark. She's looking, as you can see, pristine in a white ruffled dress by Christian Siriano. Now, look, among Laura's previous wins, she took home Emmy Gold for her turn in The Big C and for a guest starring role on Frasier. She's always so gorgeous, isn't she? Now to the inimitable RuPaul, who was on the carpet with his fellow drag race judges, that's Michelle Visage and Carson Kressley. Ru was looking, well, fierce in a leopard print tuxedo. Maria Venuti somewhere is very envious. Maybe Ru was getting in touch with his wild side, not sure. In the lead up to today's ceremony, RuPaul's Drag Race won Best Reality Show for a seventh year in a row. And for those keeping tabs, it was RuPaul's, I think, 12th Emmy win. He's going to need a bigger mantle, as they say. Forget the boat. Thelma and Louise star Gina Davis wowed in a yellow frock there. She's, look at that, a gorgeous buttercup yellow frock by Rani Zakem Couture. She's being honoured tonight with a Governor's Award. This is very special. This is for the humanitarian work that her foundation, the Gina Davis Institute, does to promote gender balance in the media. Look at her there. And let's take a look at Sandra Oh. Why in the dickens don't we? Sparkling, as you can see, in a purple sequin jumpsuit. She's nominated for Outstanding Lead Actress for her role in Killing Eve. This is her 13th Emmy nomination. And can you believe this? Despite that lofty total of nominations, her splendid work, a wonderful career, no wins so far. So question is, 13, unlucky for some, maybe not for Sandra. In fact, might this be Sandra's lucky year? Is the purple jumpsuit with all those sparkles her lucky charm? We're going to find out. Now, if she wins, she would also be the first woman of Asian heritage to win a lead Emmy. So there you go. Take a look at Emmy-nominated actress Zendaya from the series Euphoria. Many fashion commentators are saying she is an early contender for Best Dressed Star today. She's wearing a black ball gown by Valentino. Look, between you, me and the gatepost, you can't go wrong with a ball gown on a gold carpet, can you? And certainly many would say you simply cannot go wrong with Valentino. And can you believe that the Fonz, I'm talking Henry Winkler, has only taken home one Emmy Award, an amazing career going all the way back to wherever. That win was back in 2018, Most Outstanding Supporting Actor in a comedy series for that wonderful series, Barry. Well, look, he's nominated again this year, making this his, I think it's the 9th nomination. 3 of those nominations he got for Happy Days back in the day. Henry is wearing the same tie he wore when he won in 2018, so good luck charm perhaps. And while talking to People magazine, he started channeling the Fonz. Take a look at how that played out.
As a matter of fact, I knew I was going to be hot, but I wore the jacket under my tux.
It's under there.
It's under here.
Yeah, all right. Nice.
It chafes a little bit. I'm a little nervous.
Okay.
I am dressed. I have the same tie that I had in 2018.
It's a good luck charm, perhaps. Yes.
That's what my son said. He said, wear the same tie.
The tie was the key. Maybe your body of work has something to do with it, too.
It matches your beautiful eyes, I have to say.
Thank you. Oh, my God, I'm so happy I'm here.
And how sartorially splendid is that lime green tie? Look, I want to share a memorable moment from the Emmys back in 1975. This is a Throwback Tuesday clip. Now, we all remember, of course, at the Oscars a couple of years ago when Warren Beatty and Faye Dunaway had that infamous moment reading out the wrong winner of the Best Picture Oscar. It wasn't La La Land. It was, in fact, Moonlight. Well, you know, the same thing almost happened to the great queen of comedy, the one and only Lucille Ball. She was presenting an Emmy. She'd forgotten her glasses and discovered that there were, well, multiple envelopes in front of her. True to form, she pushed on, made fabulous jokes, talk about doing it while flying by the seat of her fabulous frock, and it proves why we still absolutely all do love Lucy. Take a look at this memorable Emmys moment.
And the winner is... You know, I haven't got my glasses. I picked up the wrong cards. They left all the cards here. I'm in trouble. I really am. Glasses. Anyway, the Mary Tyler Moore Show.